morning. My name is Marisa Morán Jahn. I'm an artist, filmmaker, and educator at MIT in the New School. And the pilot to my creative capital project is Video Sync Uganda, a collaboration with Ugandan and diasporan filmmakers that involves slipping and slinking experimental film shorts onto pirated, commercially pirated DVDs, so they play as previews to the main feature film. In other words, we bootlegged the bootleg. These were shown by in Uganda's bootleg cinemas and seen by millions. With the wonderful support of Creative Capital, my collaborators in Uganda and I created a series of bootleg-ready videos and photographs that explore how we see ourselves reflected and distorted in the other. These vignettes blend myths and post-colonial narratives, and they communicate what oftentimes cannot be spoken. I continued these collaborations with collaborators in other regions where freedom of speech is censored and human rights are suppressed. They communicate the ambiguities and aspirations of the subaltern, and they emblemize my work as a whole, which surfaces questions about the legal and historic forces for that sanction some subjects and render others invisible. As a Chinese and Ecuadorian woman and a mom, I use humor, dignity, and joy to reach other audiences, to broadcast to a broader audiences. This is the Care Force One Travelogues, a PBS and Sundance-supported film that I created with the National Domestic Workers Alliance. It explores solutions to our nation's care crisis as my friend Anjum, my son, and I undergo a car crisis.
One day, as I was filing some paperwork,
project builds the political power of women right now. And what I'm about to show you is a work in progress montage that is a sort of mood setting piece for what will later become a feature film. I'm sorry, more character driven and narrative driven film.
One day, as I was filing some paperwork, I came across my medical record. Inside was information about my copper IUD, and I started wondering about this piece of technology that's in my very own snatch. So I began researching who invented the copper IUD, its history, its use, how many people have IUDs, and where did the copper in my snatch come from? I needed to know what's at stake.
Natural History of Copper is a book, a film with Yael Melamed and Alex Lambert, an immersive installation with architect Rafi Segal that raises questions about who has the right to exert control over bodies and land. The installation's exterior copper skin is conductive, which means it channels electrons between the sky and the earth. It blocks out incoming cell phone signals and electrical wavelengths in the way that an IUD inside the uterus zaps incoming sperm to create an interior controlled space of intimacy. As abortion debates rage, Snatchural History of Copper focuses on a wondrous piece of ancient technology that enables family planning and the fulfillment of women's desire. I'm looking to develop this new project. Of course, I'm looking for funding, but also to present and show this new work, so festivals, museums, outdoor spaces, galleries, as well as more broadly, opportunities to create and perform artworks, create and distribute films. We're looking for an executive producer, to publish books and speaking engagements. Thank you.